Hi, everybody. This is Morgan Jennings at SciAps here with Brendan Connors.
Hi.
And we're going to show off our brand new product, the Powerhouse X. So this is a portable benchtop analyzer, fully shielded, interlocked. I'm just going to open up the Geocam app and we'll start a test while we talk more. So Brendan's got some samples here, all cupped powder samples. You can shoot powder samples like this or hand samples, small pieces of core, rock chips, anything that fits inside the test chamber here. Close the lid, start a test. So Brendan, while that's running, could you maybe tell us a little bit about what makes this special?
Yeah, so it's our new tabletop analyzer. The Powerhouse runs at up to 80 kilovolts. And so 80 kilovolt x-rays are really important for testing rare earths. The heavier elements that are difficult to test with a handheld. So we actually have a big range of elements calibrated on this. It's up to about 48 or so across the whole periodic table, but it's really specialized for the rare earth elements.
Yeah, great. And so a typical handheld would only go up to 50 or maybe 55 kV, right? So that extra up to 80 kV, you get a big boost in performance.
That's right. Yeah. So you can measure lanthanides on a rare earth elements on a handheld analyzer, but the lines that you can see on those with a handheld are going to overlap with some really common elements that show up in mineral samples like titanium, iron, copper, and a few others. And so with the 80 kilovolt system, you can access the K lines of them, which don't have overlaps with those other common elements. So we can get down to much lower sensitivity levels, much lower detection limits.
Yeah, so you really simplify things by looking at those high energy lines, right?
Definitely.
Deal with all the overlaps. Great. And so why in a benchtop form like this?
Yeah, so because the tube that's in here goes up to 80 kilovolts or a lot higher energy than what you would have in a handheld, and so for safety reasons, you want to use those in a shielded system. So the system is fully shielded, has the lid that keeps the x-rays all contained inside the sample chamber, and the lid is interlocked as well, so you can't run it without the lid closed.
Yeah, right, great. And we should also mention that it has runs on battery power, right? So it comes with two batteries. You can run for several hours in the field without any power plugged in. It's got a handle so you can carry it around, easily transport it in and out of the field.
That's right. We're running off of batteries right now, actually.
Yeah.
It has an integrated fan just for cooling so you can use it out in the field just to keep a reasonable temperature.
Yeah, and I see, so we started this test in the Geocam app, which is kind of a new piece of software for SciAps. What can you tell us about that?
Yeah, so we're also, with the Powerhouse Analyzer, we're launching our new Geocam app, which this version has three beams in it. And that covers a really wide range of elements you might want to measure. So that'll include, in addition to your rare earths, which are going to be really important to test on the Powerhouse, you can also test your base metals, so more common elements, iron, zinc, copper, as well as light elements, so down to aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, and sulfur. So you can really test the whole range of those in this this new app. And so it uses a mix of fundamental parameters and some empirical calibrations to get the best results on every element.
Yeah, nice. So you're not really like sacrificing any performance by shooting in one mode or the other mode, or having to shoot things in two different modes all the time.
Yeah,
it's all in one.
Yeah,
and it sounds like performance-wise, it does the rare earths better than any handheld, but the other elements are going to be pretty comparable to a handheld. Is that right?
Yes. Yeah.
Great. So the test finished. What do we see here?
Yeah, so this sample, it says lower PPM levels of a bunch of rare earth elements. So you have the light rare earths, lanthanum, cerium, praseodymium, a few others. But then it also contains lower levels of the heavy rare earths. So europium, gadolinium, terbium. So it's testing all of those at the same time, as well as all the other elements that I mentioned, the base metals and light elements. And it's measuring them down to low PPM levels. And so if it detects it, it'll tell you what the measured concentration is with the uncertainty. If it's not detected, it'll just give you an ND for not detected and give you the detection limit on the side.
Yeah, great. Well, thank you, Brendan. I think that's a good overview so far. Anything else you'd like to say? Or?
No. It's useful for a lot of different application areas. So mineral exploration could be useful for environmental testing or grade control. Lots of different applications where you need to measure lanthanides or other heavy elements.
Yeah. And I guess we should also mention that, you know, this kind of goes along with SciAps' push in technology towards clean energy and the electrification, electric vehicles, and critical minerals. So not only can we measure lithium with our LIBS instruments, but we can also now see all of the rare earths with our XRF. And these rare earths are critical for magnets, other technology, and they're used in all the electronics you use on a day-to-day basis. So being able to analyze these elements at low levels like this instrument can has never been more important. So really exciting.
Yeah, so if you need something that does rare earths down to both light and heavy rare earths down to PPM levels, it's the SciAps Powerhouse.
Yeah, great. Thanks, Brendan.